Hello everybody, I'm here to talk about the first Skafish album. It was recorded in 1979 and released in 1980 on one of the most groundbreaking independent labels of all time, IRS Records. I was so fortunate to be the first ever American artist signed to the label and the second worldwide. To support the first album, we toured Europe and America with such great artists as The Police, XTC, UB40, Squeeze, English Beat, Ultravox, Sector 27, U2, and the Stranglers. Much to my surprise and ultimate horror, the record company never bothered to do another pressing of the record for the years and the decades that followed. So initially, the record company did a vinyl pressing and a tiny little cassette run. After that, they did nothing and refused to do anything. So, of course, it was disturbing to me and highly upsetting to me on a multitude of levels. I contacted the record company several times and attempted to negotiate regaining the rights back so I could re-release this for my fan base. Each of those attempts were unsuccessful. However, I still had one option, and that was to utilize a law created by the United States Congress that allowed authors of intellectual property, in this instance, me, who surrendered those rights to someone else, in this instance, the record company, to regain those rights 35 years after the date of publication. And that's exactly what I did. I terminated the rights to the first album and the track Sink or Swim. The first album became legally mine in May of 2015, and just a few weeks later, the same thing happened with Sink or Swim in June. What happened after that is I started the process of remastering the record. I worked with a great mastering engineer who I've worked with on several records, Trevor Sadler. The idea for the remastering was clear to me. The vision was clear. I knew that I didn't want to take the volume and make it overly loud, which is what so many people do nowadays. I wanted to keep all the dynamic nuance in the record, both musically and vocally. So the intro on Disgracing the Family Name remains quiet. The piano intro on Take It Out on You remains quiet. And of course, the loud parts are loud, the medium parts are medium, and the soft parts remain soft. Simply what we tried to do is remain authentic to the original vision of the record and get the best possible fidelity and sound that was possible. And I believe that we achieved that. I want to say the remastering of this record would not have been possible without the tremendous generosity of my fan base. They supported this remastering process financially, without wanting anything in return, without asking for anything in return. And I will tell each of you who have contributed to this, you will hold a special place in my heart forever, one of complete gratitude and appreciation. So now what I'm looking to do is re-release the record, and in doing so, I want you to know there is no record company behind this supporting it. There is no business entity financing this. This is simply between my fans and me. This is a grassroots re-release attempt. So I put up a survey recently so that I can know very, very clearly what it is that my fan base wants. And I also need to know, is there enough fan support to even do this? Because the only way this record is going to be re-released is if the fans financially back it. And in addition to that, I need to know what everyone wants. Does everyone want vinyl, 180 gram vinyl, CD, digital, boutique items, a one-on-one meet and greet with me, and one of my favorite ideas, a listening party? So, what's happening now is the survey is up, and I want to tell each and every one of you, if you seriously intend on financially backing the re-release of the first Skafish album, take the survey now, because I need to know exactly what we're looking at. Then, I want you to know that my asking price, my total asking price, is going to be simply what it takes to manufacture the items and be able to ship them anywhere throughout the world. That's all I will be asking for. Now, on the flip side of the coin, if you're not so interested in backing the record or you're kind of unsure, do not take the survey, because it will simply confuse me in terms of what the numbers really are. I need to attempt to put this together and have the correct numbers, the correct amounts of items that we would manufacture, and the correct financial assessment of the situation. If you're interested in backing this record, go to my blog, skafishblog.com. Go to the top of the page and there will be a picture that says, "Take the survey." click on it, and that will take you to the Google Docs document where you can simply fill out the survey and let your voice be heard. You will be hearing from me soon, and I certainly hope that all is well in your world.